Hey guys, one of the most common questions I get on Inspire is what to set in the analyzer settings. So for example, element size, how do I know what to put in there? So this is an educated guess, and you can get it if you change something in the model by pressing on this flash icon, and it will just guess a number which is rather coarse, I would say, but it's definitely a number where your result will be generated very fast. You can get a little bit of a trade-off between faster results or more accurate results. That I think has to do something with the element function, first order, second order, stuff like that. But in most cases, it comes down to this, what to set for element size. And I know the measure tool in Inspire is limited, so your box measurement, it's not really that great, but you can always go, for example, to do a little sketch. Like, for example, a new sketch on this, and then you can just measure it out, like dimension, and can measure it from here to here. So this would be 20 millimeters, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, 20 millimeters. Not sure why this is. Yeah, so 20 millimeters, you see it here. Go back here. So, for example, if I want to have three or more elements, I would say, for example, 7 as a element size, or rather 6. Yeah, so this is how you set it. And the other thing is that if you just run a analysis, let me just quickly run one for you faster. Yeah, and run it. You can always check when you have a run done, you can check the elements with the results, and then you can get a visual impression and see if you think that it has a need for a small element size or not. So for example, and by the way, rainbow color for Meshsize. I urge you to use those and not, I don't know what is it called, the other one. But yeah, so you can see by a press of the button here, you can just display the elements. And so you can see, all right, well, this would definitely need some refinement. Yeah, but just that you know that you can do it like this as well. You unfortunately do not have those many control parameters with the mesh. But I think this will be a topic for another video. And that's all for today. Thanks and have a good one.